masteries end up being more sustained than you need most of the time. And it also has a AD scaling on his W. Every 5 attacks, Kennen deals bonus magic damage equal to 40% of his attack damage, and adds a mark of the storm to his target. So the 8 AD ends up adding 4, like 3 to 4 damage to your W activation. So that's really good. Not to mention, Kennen has, pretty long auto attack range, you can see it here, so it's not too hard to just smack some kids with those autos over and over. I'm actually gonna walk in here. Lulu's 01's probably stronger than mine, but I do have Ignite, so if he actually wanted to get into an all-in, I think I would win it. It's fine though. Hey guys, how's it going, everyone? Alright. I'm gonna. Would Rageblade be good on Kennen? I don't think it's that good. I mean, you can build it if you're going for like an attack speed hybrid build, and then in that kind of a build, it would be pretty solid. But in terms of like what I need for this game, I think just like full AP glass cannon, like in a so I can be in a position to one-shot all their squishies makes the most sense. So yes, you can build it, but I think the rest of your build has to kind of synergize with it too. Okay, so my next auto is gonna proc my passive and my W. That. So every time I have that passive coming up, and it's every 5 auto attacks. So on your fourth auto, you know the next auto is gonna proc. Oops, is gonna proc it. So you wanna be careful for that. So I was looking at the CS. I knew she was gonna have to go for that range creep that was about to die. So I chose that moment to make my move. Ow. Okay. I just took E level 2. A lot of people don't expect you to go so aggro on Kennen, but especially if you're running Ignite, like you do have kill potential. I gotta be a little careful here in case I get ganked or something like that. I need to poke her like a bit lower and then go for something spicy on her.
Why does this keep happening to me?
Need help like right now. Oh shit's baby thug. This guy fucked up. Oh, he got it? What? Hey now, you're an all-star. Get your game on, go play. Got it with my young Q, baby. The Penguino. Hey, man, thank you for the $10. I'm gonna flash on this beach. Watch this, guys. I earned that shit 100%. I'm gonna get ganked here. Alright, well. I killed. I should have turned my E off faster. I just kind of hesitated there for some reason. And then I got hit by the spear and died. I still killed Lulu, but I would have obviously preferred not to have died in the process, so I could have retained my double buffs and kept dunking on these kids. Oh well. It happens. Just gonna rush Source Shoes. I don't have TP, so I wanna get to lane faster. I wanna be able to roam around the map. I don't think Lulu's going to be stacking early on Mara because she's building Aroa. She went Mana Crystal and Health Crystal. And yeah, this should be fine. Although I don't have any wards. Also, our team comp is all AD, so I know that there's not... It's not very logical for them to buy MR items. So that's why Source Shoes and, like, Pen is, like, pretty clearly gonna be good. Even though Source Shoes... You know, Source Shoes are pretty expensive, there's still a solid pickup here. If I had the money to get, like, you know, Neoscar Drawn and some extra pots, I probably would have done that. But... I didn't feel very comfortable, you know, having like no sustain here. Made me a little bit sketched out. How do you get out of gold elo with Kennen, dude? Just copy the mastermind right here. See what I do with this guy, and do it in your games, like how I look to harass in lane, how do I try to initiate fights, although there's a chance I throw this game, getting too hypey, but. I'm gonna copy my good aspects, not my bad ones. Wait, what the fuck, Lulu's broken. Hit him with like, my full combo, and he just like owned me. I had to E there because she was gonna EQ me for a lot of damage. So right here, I want to hit her with the auto and then activate my W. The big deeps. Kind of tricky though. She's being a little baby. Forgot something I wanted to do before. Oh, I hit it! I wanted to do before I started streaming today. I'll do it after this game. You guys are gonna love it. Ooh, he tried to take it! But my damage came through. That's what I'm talking about, baby. This is actually really good for me. Now I can back. I can get that Needle Sealer drawed if I so choose. And I'll have, you know, enough for a pink ward and an extra pot if I need it. Yeah, let's just grab that needlessly. Abyssal is so good against them because look, magic damage. If you rush MR against some like a top jungle or mid and jungle combo, like you will probably never die. If you're not like super far behind, but I but I just don't think it's worth it because no one really benefits from the magic shred on our team. Like I said, like a lot of players would argue that you should still get it, but for me, like I need to check those two criteria before I go Abyssal, and you know maybe that's not the right mentality, but that's how I like to think about it. Ow! Lulu's broken. I'm gonna back it up. I have Ignite coming up. MR looks pretty juicy about now. Oh, the red buff. Alright, that's fine. Nice insect. Yeah, Lulu does a lot of damage. She had no bonus AP, and she was still chunking the heck out of me. Feels bad, man. All she had was the catalyst. I'm probably gonna roam bot. I saw an opportunity around bot. I wanted to go for it. They're gonna back. Fuck. She's probably just gonna push that Waven back too. Oh, she's staying? No, stay for something else. Be greedy. Fuck. Okay, I have to go back to top. What the fuck? Holy, Neely was right next to me. I didn't see her. It's so awkward. I was looking mid, and I just like walked right by Neely. And now I'm gonna miss like a bunch of CS top, because I wasted time looking bot lane, and they died. I should've... What if I can one-shot Nilly here? Oh, never mind. You're just backing. Hi. You done streaming? Pretty good. Not bad. Yeah. How are you? Really? Why? Sorry. You mean to do anything? You want ramen? Okay. They should have the dragon without me. I'm just gonna go top. Playing a Pam, by the way. Did you add the new Pam command? Yep. I updated the Pam command from the troll ass picture of her to her actual stream, because I know people were asking about that. Oh, you are dead, bitch! Wait, are you saying that because they're both Yordles? Yeah, it wasn't very cute though, because I just like went. It was like super one-sided. I like it. Yeah, but they think like homeless people can't fight, so I just beat them up after. Okay, I'm gonna back again. As a witcher, you did a nice dinner yet? Some McDonald's, perhaps? No, we're actually gonna go to probably In-N-Out for Valentine's Day dinner. Oh yeah, or we're also thinking about the free Jack in the Box burgers. Jack in the Box apparently is... Oh, you are dead too! Oh, never mind. Yeah. Stepfather, you hate me so much. No! No! I couldn't- I had no energy! Oh my god, we just got dumpstered. Wait a second. Where's the ult? Oh, he doesn't even have ult. Ooh, just kidding. Wow, I spoke too soon. Okay. What are you getting? Alright, let's see. I like rallies on Kennen if you're ahead. The slow train you can do on people is kind of OP. I think I'm gonna get rallies here. Lulu is 0-5, so she's really not worth that much gold. It's not that beneficial for our team to like keep killing her. Hey, Moon Reigns. Hey, boy, how are you doing today? I'm doing well, my man. Doing well. Thanks for asking. Just trying to get my Valentine's special stream start off on a good note. This game's going pretty well for me. Hopefully, I can carry my team. Like Valentine's Day carries awkward teenagers to give relationships a shot. I can go for this. Oh, I missed. Attack move at max range so that I can hopefully dodge like a charm or something. So I hit her and she fucking missed. So by just like taking a step back and forth every time and then predicting her movement, I hit my Q on her, forced her flash, got the slow, and it was soon to be a stun. And, basically, you don't want to just, like, sit there when you're clearing a ward, especially if they have, like, an Ahri or something like that, something that can kill you. You want to, like, be smart about it, like, move back and forth so that... I'll try it. I don't know if I want some. If it's really good, maybe. Okay. Are you mad? Okay. Blue, flash, and ultied. Oh wait, maybe she just ultied. Yeah, the Rylai's slow is nasty. Can't get away from that. It kinda has so many ways to just proc spell effects. Oh, the double tap. I love that, dude. You can get a second W off before the first one fades. Feels so good. Feels so nice. I think I had to ult just to keep her off me. Yeah, it's fine. I lose the ability to kill the, should be dead. Oh, no slow? No Q? Going around this way. Can't do it. No! Oops. Missed the cannon. Oh well. Wait, I never said Aatrox is boring. What the fuck? That's a misquote. That's a misquote. I don't remember saying that. Strike that from the record. What's a good champion you could play in top? You're kind of new at the moment. Oh shit, I missed a donation and a sub. My bad. One second. I mean, I don't know, I don't necessarily agree with what people say, like if you're a new player, only play like really mechanically easy champions. Like, I feel like playing harder champions, you know, it's not like any champion is like impossibly difficult to learn. Like, you'll get better at the game by practicing stuff that, you know, requires more than like one spell and like moving at the guy. But honestly, just play whatever like looks fun and that you see people playing at high elo, even if it's like one trick ponies. Like, you see a Wukong main or like an Aatrox main or something like that, those are all good champions. You just have to be, you know, good at them, know their limits, know how to press advantages. There's not necessarily a secret, like, secret few champions that everyone has to play or whatever. I think Voyboy is playable. I hope not. Actually, I'd be down to get played. Dad used to play with me. Go to like tennis courts, play basketball together. It's good old father-son bonding time. I don't like this Nidalee. She's like pretty ahead. Maybe I can wait here. I wanted him to get the red first so I wouldn't have to do the dirty work. That's what we call mafia mentality. You get your goons to do the work for you, and then you just take them out. He's donezo, as I like to say. Actually, I've never said that before, but I did now. Alright, I'm fed as fuck. Let's win this game. I think I'm gonna go Luden's Echo. It's just a nice AP item. And it also the proc also applies Rylai, so you get that fast slow off easily like that too. Why is it that you max W over Q? W provides better wave clear. Q is hard to hit on a range champion, especially in like when they're hiding behind creeps and stuff. And if you miss one Q, you're fucked. Whereas W, you can, you know, get a passive proc off and then calculate your fight around it. It just feels a lot more efficient, a lot more smooth. I prefer W in most cases. Ken's a really good roaming champion too, so you want to be able to like quickly clear out a wave. You don't want to have to sit there like auto Q, like it just takes forever to clear shit out. You don't want to deal with that, man. Using my E to do this is kind of risky. Oh, you bastard. Boy Scout throwing some shade? That's true. I'm going to have to give him a talking to. Alright, guys. I got that young Luden's Echo. Boy's about to pop off. Let's get it done. I am massive right now. I'm probably gonna go get blue buff too. Fun fact, energy regen is actually amazing on champions like Zed and Kennen and even Akali. And blue buff gives you bonus energy regen. The only way you can get more energy regen. So sometimes it's actually better to give blue to, you know, the ninjas than the conventional energy, I mean mana champions. Oh yeah, this looks like a good team fight. Only I was there. Holy shit. Watch me pent it, guys. Watch this shit. Fucking way. Back it up. I got denied by Janna so hard. No! You know what? Juck Fana, guys. Juck Fana. See ya! This turret should be mine too. Got it. No! Oh, the boy wonder! He gets out! He's a prodigy among men! And women. No sexism here. Damn, does that mean I should start saying the girl wonder? If I want to be gender neutral? Maybe not, since my name is Voyboy. I can get away with that. Oh shit. See ya. Oh, where are you going, kid? Say hello to my little friend. The ride lies slow, that never ends. See ya, nerd. I fucking love this champion, dude. I was being so greedy with my, like... Actually, I don't even know. I probably should have just not chased him into the Nexus. I'm not winning the game that hard yet. Oh, nice exhaust. Got it for free, basically, there. You read your comments. Test 14. I do read the chat, but I'm not going to respond to I can't respond to everything, obviously. Just because you typed it 14 times doesn't mean I'm, you know, woefully ignorant. Or that I'm not reading. You had ignite. I did, but it was out of range. At least it was. I might have been in range at some point, but I thought I could get him without using it. Nice. So I held on to it. Maybe a mistake. Who knows? To be honest, I'm usually not going to respond to something that says, do you read the chat, or like test 15, but I didn't want to keep you copy and pasting the same thing, man. I would feel too bad. Oh, bitch. I don't know why I call her that. That's just like the name I give Lulu now. Oh no, you don't! See ya, nerd! Yeah, I'm just going off, dude. People say Ken's not viable. I say he's broken. Alright, baby, I got Death Cap. Death Cap, Ludens, Rylai's. You know I mean business now. That's all I gotta say. Yeah, I'm just literally gonna flash into their whole team when I have ult up and look for the one shot. Gonna AFK for 30 seconds. Oh wait, we're actually team fighting. Never mind. Holy shit, 12 seconds. If I can kite this out, dude, be a god. 4 seconds. 4 seconds. 4 seconds. Three people that are just walking away from me. Woo! Damn, I was hoping Ari would be there too. Oh wait, what? Is she right here? Yeah, she is. What the fuck? Shit. Accidentally use my No! I need two more assists for my score to be 13-37 for Leet, as we call it on the internet. It's my dream, dude. be elite. Come on. Give it to me. Oh, get out of here, boy! Oh, God. It's just back, I think. You know? Look how much MR they're buying. They got Locket QSS, dude. I'm the only AP. That's how you know you played the game well. You've commanded that much respect. When they have to buy MR. Okay. Dr. Penguino, hey man, so sorry for the delay. I was just super into this game. Thank you for the 10 bucks, bro. He said, here's something to start your stream off. Hype. Thanks, Penguin, my man. And Seraphal sub. Thank you, Seraphal. Can we get some boy Yasuos? Where my subs at, guys? Throw it up. Poor Seraphal. Show some love for our latest sub. Thank you so much. And thanks for the donation as well, man. Alright, guys, I'm going to clear top here. I really want to avoid getting any kills or deaths here and just look for those two assists so I can end the game elite. That's my goal. That's my goal here, boys and girls. I have no flash. Sierra boots are pretty nice because they give you like the reduced summoner spell cooldown. But sword shoes just made sense this game, and I had like the perfect gold for it when I backed too. Always memeing again. You know it. Let me in there! I feel when you have no flash on Kennen. You can't get into a 5-man clump. Feels bad, man. I didn't even get an assist there. How do we manage not to kill anyone? I just back, honestly. Oh, that Rylai's slow. I'm just gonna back and get my juicy void staff here. Oh, I don't even have gold for it. Damn, I suck. I'm gonna get blue and then back, get void, and then go team fight, because at that point my flash will be— oh, what? My flash will be up and I can just like one shot. Oh wow, my flash and my ult are on the pretty much the same cooldown here. Kinda cool. Not going Abyssal is a little bit risky, but they don't really have much physical damage, so I think the armor would be mainly wasted. Late game, when like gold values start to matter less, you should definitely put in an Abyssal into your build. So like, I'm probably gonna go Abyssal next. I just wanna like do as much damage as possible here, so that I can look really cool when I like flash in and try to one-shot their team. That's my goal anyway. So let's see if I can do it, guys. If I get like Whimsied or something or Polymorphed, it's gonna kind of suck. But I think our team is strong enough that even if I don't get the perfect initiation off, we should still be okay.
Save the boy! Save the kid!
Alright, we win. Hey, lame-o. I didn't get my two assists, but did win the game, so I'll take it. 15, 4-7. Nice first win of the day for that Valentine's Day special. Let's go, boys. Let's do it.